Hey everybody, more La-Mulana 2. So, I did do a little bit of, review, prior to coming back to the game. How much that review is actually going to help, I'm not really sure. I think I've more accounted for the problems or things that I'm interested in solving rather than actually having solved any of it. But here's what I will say. So, the things that I was reviewing or trying to discover more about with great interest pertained to things to do with the underworld, things to do with Maat's ritual, Amit, things to do with the golden rock and the pyramid crystal. But, like, a lot of these things seem very intertwined. Because Amit is the one that is crushing my face, apparently, if I'm not innocent, or something like that. Yeah, the undead Amit will render the judgment. So, I know that Amit hides in the Garden of the Stars, and that the Pyramid Crystal is required to do away with the power of the stars that cloaks the garden where Amit is. So there's kind of a suggestion there of, okay, do I need to get the Pyramid Crystal and then fight Amit? And then that kind of allows me to access the Room of Judgment, or does it? Are those things independent? Don't know. And then if I need the Pyramid Crystal, well then what do I do with the Golden Rock? Now the reason why I'm kind of like, this seems a little bit intertwined with all of the stuff in the underworld, is because I need to balance Maat's feather and complete the ritual to receive judgment, you know. The kind of judgment where I don't wind up dead at the end. Receive judgment, speak to Anubis, pass the three trials, hopefully. Because the last gate to hell, where the scythe-wielding death god awaits, his scythe afflicts death upon those who retire along the path. So, there was a suggestion that it's like, okay, well you don't get access to Osiris unless you've spoken to Anubis and he's sort of made that available to you. So can I even go down the path that I'm almost suggesting with the underworld? Or that I've mapped out a little bit? Does that even have any meaning if I get to the last gate and Osiris just blows me out anyway because he's afflicting death? Although it's not necessarily, you know, me retiring along the path, but there was that kind of connection with Anubis and scythe-wielding death god, which I think is Osiris, because there was another tablet that talked about the underworld deity, the Aeneid, having the scythe. And I need to get the scythe so that I can then go give that to what's her name, so that I can get the power of the flame, possibly access to Surtur's room, and then I can use the power of the flame in like some other stuff, like with Vidofnir in the Icefire Treetop. Which again is something that's just like a little bit weird, because it's sort of like, that's entrance to the underworld, but like I have entrance already? Or is that the first gate along the path? Because that's another thing that I've been struggling with. So, I went through, and I kind of went with the ordering that was given to me by Nitty, the gatekeeper. So the golden gleaming wrist guard, and then the lunar breastplate, and then the something rustic and repurposed, and then the golden wings. Or no, it's something rustic and then something repurposed. So then the repurposed. And then the last one is, what is it, Svafa's? The Glove of Power. So I have those six, and I have a path to get down all of those that I've worked out. It's just a case of, okay, well, where is the starting point? Kind of. Because the starting point should be like the golden chalice, but I don't have any gates that have the golden chalice like displayed on them. So I was musing previously, well, perhaps that's the Corridor of Blood, because it takes away an item when I go through that door. The problem with that is that the Corridor of Blood takes me into Doom, and in order to follow this path that I've laid out, and I don't think there's any other path that I can actually access that's coherent with the other hints that I have, I need to be in Gloom. And there's no way that I know of that I can get from Doom to Gloom without entering one of these doors that otherwise I would need to go in to follow this path. And because doors shut after you've been in them, that causes some problems for me. Also, it's like the second door that you go in removes the golden gleaming wrist guard. So like if I was to go in the door at the bottom of Blick Jandabul, that takes away my grapple claw, which means that I can't go in door number two, and that's also the second door that I'm going in. So I'm already kind of fucked. So I need to be in Gloom to start off. So the one idea that I had on the back of that was potentially... So there is another door that leads in from outside of the Eternal Prison in here. And it's above me here. Yeah, right by the like the River Styx crossing, which is this one. So it doesn't have anything on here, but where's this come from? Oh. Right. Great. So, yeah. That was basically the thought that I was having. Is that it's like, okay, if I go in this door, then maybe that counts as the first gate, and then I can go immediately to the second gate, which I would then be able to access pretty easily. Unfortunately, I can't get in that gate unless I kill Vidofnir. And I can't kill Vidofnir unless I have the searing, like the power of flame or whatever, right? Which I do not have. And I don't have anything even remotely kind of approaching that. It also, I had a thought about this while I was off stream. I was wondering whether or not this was something that I actually was supposed to have to solve the puzzle with Aji Sakita Hakuhone or whatever, the doppelganger. Because this tracks enemies, and then, you know, it's like, oh, I equip this, and then I go into the room, and then I shock the crap out of that, which is, like, the intended solution, and I kind of did it wrong, but whatever. It's no going back there. So I can't really do anything about Vidofnir here. Interesting. You just stand here. And not, like, you don't take damage from being down here. Or anything. From his little neck you do, but... yeah. So that was... yeah. Okay. So that's sort of... that. Because there aren't any other ways in here. That I know of. That would be helpful. Damn. And then, yeah, the reality of the situation up here is, well... this one is... oh, hang on. Ah, pardon me. I need to sneeze. This one would be the second door in the ordering that I'm kind of looking at. Because basically I would go in here, which takes me to door 15, and then I would need to go to door 13, which is this way. And that takes me to door 7. Then I need to go in door number 4, which is not this one, but oh, bugger off. But up here. You can see how I'm, like, kind of behind in a way that makes sense with respect to the items that I'm using. So that takes me out 6, then I need to go in 8. Which is not this way. I also didn't find anything that would help me in this room, that I know of. Oh man, what kind of fairy is it gonna be? Well, okay, never mind. So door number 8 is this one, to my right. So then that takes me to door 16. Just right here. And then we want to go in door number 14. Wrong way. Which is this one. Although that is interesting, because if that takes away the feather, I'm one door ahead of where I would be. I'm not sure that I can get from door 16 to door 14 without the feather. And then it would be the last door here, which I would go in. But of course, I've only been in six doors, which means that this is death. Of course, it might also be death had I been through seven doors, based on my observations having to do with the other things. I want to go and take a look at... go to Blue Jean de Bolivar real quick right here. Oh, right. I can't just jump up. So the issue of contention for me is one of... like, if I get to this point... right? I'd be coming out of door 16 with no feather. And this is door 16. So how... like, if I don't have the feather, I can't get out of here. Nettie does say something about, like, if you can't proceed further down the path, you know, you could always die. But I don't think that that's, I don't think that that's meant necessarily as an actual hint. Though maybe, I mean, like, they are giving me something to kill myself with right here. So the reason why I come in here is because I'm giving up the golden wings. Now there is another... yeah, the only other door that has the golden wings on it is... well... it's this one. So... so how would I... how would I even deal with that? Huh. I don't really know. Kind of interesting that if you change clothes in midair, it like stops your momentum. It's a bit weird. if I was able to get up here, then I'm pretty sure I can get there without the... without the feather just fine. Ooh, wait a minute. Okay, no. Never mind. I've answered a different question for myself. So, no, I wouldn't be able to get up there without the feather. Because the only ways to get up there would be either through... Well, can I push this thing? No. Because I need to be able to get up there, or I would need to be able to get down here. I need the feather for both of those. So then, yeah, like, how would I get to the, how would I get to that gate? Damn. Yeah, I mean, I have the order, right? It's just parts of it that don't... like, I can't quite stack up to. So I went through this ordering particularly... I mean, one, because... like, it's the only way that it really makes sense. But, again, I think, as I talked about on the last segment, I have to be able to go through 2 and 4, like, just as doors. Like, even if I knew nothing else about the order of the doors, I would have to go through doors 2 and 4 early on in the sequence, because the fact of the matter is that I can't go through them later, because the grapple claw and the rustic clothing, you know, like the clay doll outfit, get taken away from you very early on. The second item that's taken from you is the golden gleaming wrist guard, the grapple claw. So, if that's not the second door that you go in, you can't go in that door. And that takes you to Doom, and then the only places that you can actually go through a door that continues to lead deeper into hell in Doom are the one by Neddy the Gatekeeper, which has the symbol for rustic and repurposed, and then the one in Blikjandabol, which has the lunar breastplate sigil on it. And the problem, like, if I was to say, well, what if I went through the door by Nettie the gatekeeper earlier? That leads to a part of Doom that I can't get out of. Like, as you saw earlier, that goes to the place where really the only gate that continues to lead deeper into hell is the final gate. So, I certainly can't go through there. So I wind up going through the one in Blackjandable, which takes me back to Gloom, at which point the next item that's on the docket is the rest of clothing, and it's also the one that would be taken away on the next entrance. And you have to have the clay doll outfit to go through door number 4, which is the one with the two, like the pink wavy lines, or whatever. I think that's what Mulberg referred to them as. And that lines you in 6, which is also in Gloom. So at that point in time, you've already gone through the two other doors in Gloom that lead deeper into hell. The only exceptions there would be using one of the fake doors to go to Blackjandable. But then the problem with that is that, well, there's no other door that leads deeper into hell that has the golden wings tied to it. Like, the only one that's red and has golden wings is, well, door 8, which is in Gloom. And that's where it takes you to door 16, which is where I'm like, ah, crap, what do I do then? Because I don't have the feather at that point, so how do I get out of there? Out for yourself. Thanks, Nettie. You've been a great help. Why can I... Oh, okay. It's like, why can I not grapple onto the... That's weird. I can't grapple onto, like, the wall up here. Whatever. There's this thing, too. Never actually... Like, I don't know why this exists. It's just a rock. That clinks. I have more mantras here. I could potentially try and work that up for the purpose of chanting them. But I need the pyramid crystal, which I do not have. I can't do anything in this room. So I would need to... I need the thing. I need the proof of judgment, which I do not have, because I have not passed Ma'at's ritual, because I do not understand it. I think every time I've scanned it, I've, like, died afterward. Yeah. I have no business with those without proof of judgment. He doesn't say anything else. These blue lights, I've never actually interacted with them. I know the hints talk about them being, like, they correspond with lords and words and yada yada. Ow. So, one of the ideas that I had briefly was relating to the Room of Judgment. And all that. Which is essentially what just happened. Because I was trying to think of other ways in which I could other ways in which I could sort of describe what's going on with the hints. Because judgment will be rendered before Ma'at. To be prepared for judgment is to have a wicked heart. An innocent heart knows no wickedness, an innocent heart can balance scales. So again, being prepared for judgment, that. And then the body must be innocent and free of excess. So things that I had tried previously had to do with, like, an amount of health that I had, I think. Because my thought was, well, you know, being prepared, going out, healing up to full, doing all that. That didn't work. So the other thought that I had was, okay, well, what if it's... what if I get rid of all of my soul stones? Because the more soul stones that you have, like, you're not free of excess, maybe. The problem is that I don't think that they roll over cleanly, because I just was in the Eternal Prison and I picked up, like, one of the big soul stones, and it, like, I got the heal up, but then I got an additional amount of soul stones, so I don't know that there's an accurate way that I could track having enough, or, like, zero soul stones. Like, I look like I'm pretty, like, it seems as though I don't have any, but I might have, like, a couple, one or two, and it's just not showing up visually. I mean, I may as well go in there and get crushed, so at least I can eliminate the idea. So I guess I'll do that now. Yeah, well, there's that. I'm gonna go and take a, okay, this shit is not gonna fly. I'm not going to have a freaking quick save while I'm wearing that damn thing. So let me take a look at the room in a little bit more detail, I guess. So, we have the big crocodile chompy mouth and the tablet that you can scan and then immediately die. I don't see any kind of iconography on the scale itself, like in the middle. The statue of Anubis appears to be holding some kind of, like, gemstone or something. Like, it does look like an Ankh jewel. I think I've been in here before looking at it, I was like, oh, does it mean the La-Mulana talisman? I couldn't imagine the Lamp of Time would actually help me in here. I'm gonna try it anyway. M- my being innocent, I don't think, includes trying to subvert the purpose of the room. Apart from that, I mean, the stuff on the walls and on the ceiling and on the floor, like, it's all pretty standard fare for the Dark Star Lord Mausoleum. I don't see anything that's super out of place. There's these three pots, which are a bit like... they're kind of weird. You'd almost think that... I don't know. It's like, why are they stacked up like this? There's a couple of other hints that I don't quite understand either, though. Well, hang on, let's do this and then... okay. Well, I'm not getting horribly murdered. Prepared for judgment is a wicked heart. Innocent heart knows no wickedness. Innocent heart can balance the scales. Undead Amit won't render the judgment. It does show the person on the scales kneeling. Though that might just be how they've done the artwork. Is there anything else up here that is relevant? Like, I don't see anything above. There's, like, something above Anubis, but I can't quite, like, make out if it's, like, meaningful or relevant or... I don't know. Let me in! You bastard! What? That's almost certainly not the intended solution to this puzzle. Bad things have occurred. Really bad things. So, the interesting thing for me here is almost like, are there two parts to this room that I'm just not understanding? So, perhaps there's the part down here with the jaws is like a puzzle unto itself. And then, oh god, I've, like, completely bugged the game out. Dude, there's so much money. I love it. But then I got crushed anyway when I was on top of the, when I tried to balance it out. So now it's like, oh great, is there, like, two distinct things to it? The other thing that I could possibly think of is like, oh, you need to be free of excess. I had a thought that it's like, do I need to have no money? Which would be really weird for me because they've already had a puzzle, and maybe this is just meta thinking at this point, but they've already had a puzzle in the game that related to having very little money. So if you'll recall, getting across the River Styx, I needed to have, like, one coin and only one coin. It's possible that they're talking about something like that, but I don't know. I'm feeling very skeptical about it. Alright, doubt anyone has anything more to say on the subject. No. Oh, right. I'm like thinking, man, there's like all of these things that clank and whatnot. There are actually bombs in the game. I totally forgot about it. Okay. So... La-Mulana. Bomb. Bomb to the bottom right of a sexy girl. Okay. It's a little weird hint. Miracle Witch, why? Alright. Well, he's not going to be helpful. I suppose I could... I could save it, spend all of my money, and then try, but... I'm not feeling super happy about that. Nothing here. I haven't visited Mulbrook in a while. She did say something briefly about, you know, oh, wow, like a crusher, like as soon as you come in. We should check that out. And then, like, nothing ever came of that. That reminds me, in the middle of this here Immortal Battlefield, inside a big-ass boat is the Soul Gate. The one with 9 soul seals. I wonder how you get inside there. Maybe the entrance is hidden somewhere in the ruins? Have something useful for me, Mulbrook. Who plays video games on their tablet while exploring? Real talk. Cool stuff can happen if you load it up together with a game app. Your dad told me about it a long time ago. Things are only going to get tougher from here on out, so you better learn all the tricks you can. Yeah. Load up Miracle Witch and Space Capster to call on the Treasure Fairy. Some items are expensive, and ammo costs really build up, so be sure to bring the Treasure Fairy around with you and make that bank. Thanks, Mulbrook. Guess I'll write it down just so it's confirmed. I actually had a sheet where I was writing down software combos. Somewhere. And this would be great if I could get Miracle Witch. Huh? Load up Miracle Witch and Future Development Company to... What's this? Materials say inaudible voices become audible. Maybe someone in an empty room hears or something? Okay. So, Miracle Witch and Mirai equals... Possibly like a... like developer secret or something? Notes from them. Huh? So Miracle Witch plus Death Village. So it's a hot spring improvement. Invulnerable to lava, prevent ammo from being consumed. Maybe that was the one that I missed. Because I was thinking it was going to make my thrown weapons better, but... La-Mulana and La-Mulana 2. Okay. Really want to try combining those two. Don't know what it does, though. And then this one again. Kind of wondering if she's reaching from these randomly. Yeah. And then Miracle Witch. And Curry is Key Fairy. Some puzzles that can't be solved without the Key Fairy. You don't say. And then Bounce Shot. Man, this Miracle Witch software seems super handy. Boy, wouldn't it be nice if I had it. Just wanted to roll through a couple more of these. Just in case she's picking them randomly and just hasn't selected one that I would want to know. Have you met with the fairies yet? They'll help you with all sorts of things, but sometimes the one you'll need won't show up. If you have the Miracle Witch game app, you can call out specific fairies. You can combine it with other game apps to call out the particular fairy you need. Miracle Witch can be combined with lots of other things too. You're really gonna wanna pick it up. I feel like the game is making fun of me now. Alright, I think I've got basically what I'm gonna get out of that. Fuck me, dude. God damn it. Like, just... God damn it. And up yours, too. Stupid yelling, Gary. I've had another dumb idea. Another really dumb idea. Okay. So... I don't even know if I want to engage in this, to be honest. Because I can't actually fully do what it is that I want to do. Oh, I want the money! I'm not gonna stop me, skeleton. Okay, so. Oh, jeez. That's right. There's a statue over there. Oops. Beautiful sound. I Oh, I'm gonna be here a while. If it's not painfully obvious, what I'm trying to do right now is I'm attempting to remove my excess and the amount of preparedness I have by getting rid of all of my sub-weapons. Or sub-weapon ammo. Whoever walks over that spot is gonna have a really bad day. So that's all of my sub-weapon ammo that I can get rid of. Hopefully it doesn't count the Ankh jewels, because I'm not getting rid of those. Yabba-dabba-doo. Alright. Well, that didn't do anything. Talk to the Fairy Queen. So... Yes, yes. Heard that tale before. She has nothing valuable to contribute beyond that. So... Ah, damn. So the painful thing for me right now is definitely in and around the idea of, okay, like, I have very strong reasoning or suspicion as to where Miracle Witch is, but I don't know how to get it. I have no idea how to get in there. Because what? Like, I went into that spot, and then, like, hot damn, I was wailing on that thing for minutes. Because I was just having the thought, it's like, well, like, I want this. I need it. I need it in my life. Potentially things that, like, I don't know, again, about the state of the dragon room below, or on the dragon path, the secret area. Like, do I wind up needing a key fairy for that room? Do I not? What's the score, right? And then there's all sorts of other hints that talk about going somewhere with a small key. They could all just be leading to things that I don't need, but I might want. But I'm stuck in a position where I don't know that that's the case. It may absolutely be that you need the key fairy to accomplish things. And that I just... ugh. Haven't made that happen yet, or, you know, whatever it is. I don't know. Guy's a total liar, by the way. He's like, I know the secrets of the underworld. It's like, no, dude, you know one secret about the underworld. Like, stop talking shit. You know one thing and one thing only, and that's all you've said the entire time that I've known you. So, you know, up yours. I mean, it's right up here. I mean, the thing that's really torturous about this is that it is making the right sound. Like, this is the sound that you would get when you are successfully destroying something. And yet, like, I'm clearly not. And I didn't last time. When I used, I'm pretty sure that's a clink sound. So that's not... like, I'm not making progress using sub-weapons. Or at least that's the kind of idea, right? Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely a clink. It's entirely possible that the software and it being behind the wall is supposed to take, like, you know, 70 billion hits, and that I just haven't been exercising the appropriate amount of patience in attacking the ceiling, like, all fucking day. But I really don't think that this is doing anything. Okay. What else could I be doing here? Like, Zelpad. What is this one? Skeet, 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 snap. He doesn't say anything along the... like, anything that would suggest, oh, I have to chant a mantra in the area, or anything along those kinds of lines. Right? God, I love how, like, literally everything that I talk to Mulbrook with, it's like, Miracle Witch and Space Capstar, Miracle Witch and Future Development Company, Miracle Witch and Death... Village, Miracle Witch and McCurry Master, Miracle Witch and Bounce Shot. It's like it's the only fucking program in the entire game. that you can make compost with in this way. Like, there's others, but yeesh. Okay, well, I wasted a bunch of sub-ammo, like, poking around in it. Other avenues have to do with... Just like, I got nothing on that one. Nothing at all. And then with this... Wow! Like, I also really have nothing. I have... our bust of Mimir. And I have no ideas in terms of what I would want to incant in front of this thing. So... like, this one kind of made sense in terms of roof. Because it's like, hey, I'm going to create a roof over my head so I don't get totally bodied by this giant rock. But, like, I don't even know about the other ones. Like, maybe... tremor? That you could cause, like, an earthquake or something like that? That will cause the thing to crack on its own? I feel like I've chanted some of the mantras here before. I mean, I haven't gone through... what I haven't done is stand here just randomly trying shit, being like, oh, maybe this'll work. Like, tremor's something that would make sense, just in that sort of way, so... justify doing that, but... yeah, like, I don't think that there's... like, no interest in standing here doing that. Stores the power of the stars. And then I think I've also tried, what was it, sun and moon? Or sun, moon, and heaven? Because it's like, okay, if it's storing the power of the stars, maybe I have to chant something to do with the stars in order to get... oh man. In order to get it open, but... like, I really don't have, really lacking any kind of strong direction on what I could do with that. So... so apart from this stuff... which I'm really not making any headway at the moment with. My other options... options are what? There's not a lot. So, there is the section up here with the... what do you call it? Right? like the divine liquor. Unfortunately, I'm pretty sure that I just don't have what I need for that either. That is the medicine of the eternal life, sought after by countless deities, a gift of paradise that restores life after death. The horn blast of the end disappears into the wind of those who wish for eternity. Night continues for eternity toward the child's road left by the mother. So, this is like 9 of the mantras, and I don't have all of them. I have wind, I have eternity, actually no, eternity is twice, so that's kind of weird. But yeah, the other ones, like I don't have end, I don't have, I don't have mother, road I have, child I don't have. There was also the note that I had about the Well of Mimir, which I haven't been super possessed about going after or investigating, because the fact of the matter is that I'm pretty sure I don't have what I need for that either. Is the Well of Divine Liquor, grant the mother's wish with a howl for that which is missing. So I don't have howl, and I don't have mother. You could interpret howl as scream, but I do have missing, but again, I don't have mother, so that one's kind of, well, moot. I think there was the idea that I had of... This one has howl, wish. And then pursuing all of this, like, that's not gonna go anywhere. Because, like, night? I don't really have night either. Missing I have, you know, again, wish, howl, but then this one, the final gate being pried upon by excessive power and the price it demands and murderous blood-drenched intent, which I would presume means, you know, all the mantras. And of course, there's the one mantra that I don't know how to access, which is in here. Now, if I had to guess at this point, given the fact that it's clinking like that, rather than chant something in this room or bring, like, a key fairy in here, I think it's entirely possible that I need to hit the wall with a grenade. You know, I totally forgot they existed. But then the question is, okay, well, whereabouts would I go in getting grenades? Because there are some places that have some chests that I haven't opened. Like, the Dragon Path Room has a chest. Hell has a chest. Though I don't know if that's one of those. I think there was one in Surtur's room. Maybe? I feel like I remember seeing one there. I'm more musing now than I am investigating for any value. Yeah, there's one in there. So there's a chest in there. There are... there's the chest in... the Room of Judgment, though presumably that has something to do with, you know, being judged. And then, of course, there's the chest in the Ancient Chaos that I haven't opened, but that has the map in it. Fuck, dude. Feeling pretty rammed up at the moment. I'm not really sure where to go. I think the only other thing that I can think of that is like, oh hey, I could investigate that, is the whole, where am I going? Where do I want to go? I came here for a reason. Right. I want to go down the pit. So the only other thing that I'm kind of thinking is like, ooh, that's something that I could possibly investigate or do. Is investigate this cat. And see what I could do about, you know, tracing their steps throughout, and taking a look at those tablets. Previously, I had one saved in here, and I wrote down a note to be like, hey, go and scan this, or make notes of that, which is something that I haven't done. But I don't... like, I remember there being a couple of tablets like that, and I almost feel like I'd want to go around and investigate as many of them as I could, which means, like, just a whole bunch of boring wandering, and... honestly, I don't have the patience to do that right now. I feel like I feel like this entire session has just been one big dud. Not just in the sense of, you know, not really figuring out anything new, but even some of the other stuff. So, like, looking at my map of the underworld and being like, well, this doesn't make sense. How could I get there if I don't have X? So it's almost like I feel like I've taken steps back. Not really. I mean, I haven't actually taken steps back. More information is always good. But I guess it's just more the feeling than anything. Which happens. I also think it's frustrating in that sense of receiving some kind of confirmation about, ooh, go and get, you know, wow, Miracle Witch does this, Miracle Witch does this. Man, Miracle Witch is a really great software. Oh, it would be really handy if you got your hands on Miracle Witch. Fuck you. So, not knowing what to do about that, not knowing what to do about the Golden Rock, not knowing what to do about the mod ritual, not knowing what to do about the underworld. It's just a lot of fucking question marks. So, I highly doubt that I'm going to record my another set of wandering around the ruins and looking at tablets. I'll see if I can jot down all of the notes that I can find about Ratatotsuka. And maybe that's the direction to go in. And I'll continue to think about the other things, I guess. But for now, I'm taking off, so have a good one.